Now, your forecast first from KARK4.
Plenty of sunshine across Arkansas today, and believe it or not, a lot of places finally made it above the freezing mark. Here in Little Rock, 89 hours at or below freezing, but feeling awfully good across the area today. We are looking for another cold night tonight, although not quite as cold as what we've seen as of late. Most places only dropping down to the mid to upper teens, northeast Arkansas, and even as mild as the upper 20s, far southwest. Here in Little Rock, we're looking for clear skies overnight tonight. We're going to start your Thursday at 19. Arkansas News That Matters starts right now.
Now, from the station you count on for local news that matters and the home of Super Bowl 52 and the 2018 Winter Olympics, this is KARK4 News at 6.
There are no secrets that we have strained relationships in many of our minority communities that have crime problems.
2017 was a violent year for the capital city, from multiple murders to a mass shooting at a Little Rock nightclub. Good evening, I'm Ashley Katz.
Hello, good evening, everybody. I'm Bob Clausen. Many calling on Little Rock's leadership to step up and bring solutions to curb the violence. Little Rock Police Chief telling us what he learned last year. KARK4's Tyler Thompson sitting down with Little Rock's top cop, who says that he's ready to set new plans in place for 2018.
That's right, Bob and Ashley. When I asked Chief Buckner what impacted him the most last year, he revealed to me that it was seeing young people become victims of homicides here in the capital city. Well, in his first interview of the new year, Chief Buckner revealed to me a few things he's wanting to change and introduce in 2018 as the community hopes for a continued and enhanced fight against violence.
I sit back here, you know, this is our control board.
The mic is hot and phone lines are open.
Our motto is voice of the people.
KABF Community Radio raises its antenna here on the south side of Little Rock.
That's how we sustain ourselves.
Tony Orr runs the station and two talk shows.
And then we go directly into what's the hottest thing going.
In 2017, that included blue lights, yellow tape, and a soundtrack of gunfire.
Comes a point in time where we, the people, have to make those that are elected accountable.
Speaking out for the first time in 2018, Police Chief Kenton Buckner envisions change, too.
There are no secrets that we have strained relationships in many of our minority communities that have crime problems.
Buckner revealed three things coming soon. A new initiative with the U.S. Attorney Cody Hyland's office, 12-hour shifts for uniformed officers, and a website feature dedicated to unsolved homicides. 29 of those happened in 2017.
So now I would just ask the public to make sure that you're doing your part with your son, your daughter, your neighborhood. But we can't be a spectator to many of the things that frustrate us.
Both Buckner and Orr agree responsibility stretches past a police uniform.
We can't leave it all to them to make these changes.
A new year with a new outlook, raising the bar for a better community.
You can only get to the comfortable after you get through the uncomfortable. 2017 was uncomfortable for a lot of people.
And Chief Buckner told me, aside from a few shootings, 2018 so far in these first few days has been relatively quiet, and he credits the cold weather for some of that, keeping some people off the streets and in the house. Live in Little Rock tonight, Tyler Thompson, KARK4 News. Back to you.
All right, Tyler, thanks very much. Mills High School students back in class today, but the campus's heating problems weren't completely resolved. According to PCSSD, a pipe burst during school hours, but it didn't disrupt class. However, before students arrived this morning, the staff was busy cleaning up the pink solution that you're about to see here. It's from one of its boilers. The heating unit busted overnight, along with the pipe in one of the bathrooms. Four classrooms were without heat today, but we're told students were moved to avoid the cold temperatures. A West Little Rock neighborhood lost power four times in the last 2 weeks. According to Energy Arkansas, system overloads can be expected during this peak energy season, but almost every recent outage in the neighborhood is blamed on something different. They include equipment malfunctions, small animals, and overloaded grids. One new homeowner in the neighborhood says this is a trend that she's not willing to get used to.
I understand that power is going to go out from time to time, but this is just evidently some sort of a system issue, and it needs to be addressed.
Entergy says during the winter months, restoring power takes longer because of demand for energy. If too many systems are re-energized at the same time, it could damage the power grid and cause more outages. Also, underground power lines are more difficult to repair because workers can't see the equipment that easily.
The suspect accused of shooting and killing a man on Dixon Street in Fayetteville appeared in court this morning. 25-year-old Christopher Rankin faces a first-degree murder charge. A judge ordered set at 2. Accused of killing 22-year-old Trenton Coney. The two allegedly got into a fight after Coney approached Rankin while he was talking to a woman. According to police, Rankin took off from the scene immediately, but he was found a little time later.
Certainly, we would all like some relief from some debt, but you got to be careful where you're looking. Scammers from out of state are preying on central Arkansans who are drowning in debt.
KARK4's Jesse Tenor spoke with an investigator who sees these types of cases, and they've actually tracked down now how they're able to do this, Jesse.
Yeah, Ashley and Bob, this is pretty interesting. She found the scammer source as a popular court records website. Court Connect is a free resource for the public, but she says it's costing a handful of victims thousands of dollars.
I can't believe I fell for it.
This 56-year-old North Little Rock woman, who wished to remain anonymous, racked up $6,000 in credit card debt. When she got a message on her phone,
"Are you in debt? Would you like to be contacted?"
She answered, "Yes." A man from out of state offered to consolidate her debt and raise her credit score for $4,000 in Best Buy gift cards.
I was like, "Hey, that sounds good."
But turns out, it was too good to be true. A scam. She's now $10,000 in debt.
It's pretty bad, but it's a lot of money involved there.
Athena Pettingill has investigated cases like this for 13 years.
All kinds of crazy stuff.
She found this North Little Rock woman isn't alone. Several others have lost thousands in iTunes gift cards to a similar scammer.
That's what kind of piqued my interest, you know. It's like, where and how are these people from another state getting our information? I mean, getting these people's information in our state.
Pettingill tracked down the source, the court records website, Court Connect.
You've got everything you need right there.
All it takes is a name of one person with financial problems. Without giving too much away, the site then compiles similar cases with names and addresses.
People's financial information, I think that's just going a step too far.
As a regular user of Court Connect, Pettingill views the site as a great tool for criminal cases.
And I think that information should be readily available to anybody.
But she believes information should be sealed for people who only show up here for financial problems.
This has got to stop.
The victim doesn't understand how scammers started this in the first place.
I don't see how they can live with themselves.
And just a reminder for all of you at home, if you have fallen victim to this or any other scam, make sure to file a complaint with the Attorney General's Consumer Protection Division. Back to you.
All right, Jesse, thanks very much. Arkansas is one of the top states for flu activity right now. According to Walgreens, the capital city is at number 8 in the country for people who are suffering from the flu. Walgreens provides the information using retail prescription data for antiviral medications that are used to treat influenza across the nation. Arkansas's Department of Health said last week that 12 flu-related deaths have happened in the natural state so far this flu season.
Still ahead this evening. Are you feeling lucky tonight? Well, this is the Powerball jackpot continues to grow. Just how much you could win, we'll take a look.
Plus, a man is behind bars for allegedly beating his son and two other women in Saline County. We have a live report from Bryant coming up.
And clear sailing all across Arkansas as folks making their way home in this webcam shot on 630 westbound. We've got temperatures that aren't so cold for your drive home either. In Little Rock today, our high temperature up to 40. That's after 89 hours of below freezing temperatures. Another cold front's coming through tonight. We'll let you know what it means for your tomorrow. Next.
You're watching KARK4 News at 6 with Ashley Katz, Bob Clausen, Chief Meteorologist Keith Monahan, and Drew Amon with your Pig Trail Nation report. Watch KARK4. Local news that matters tonight.
Hank's end of the year.
Sale of the year.
$1,500 sectionals, $8.99. $1,000 sofa love sets, $5.99.
And your sales tax paid.
And Hank's fine furniture.
And mattresses.
At Simple Truth, we're proud of what's in our food. Like sun-ripened oranges, grass-fed beef, organic greens, and amazing flavor. Also proud of what's not in our food, like GMOs or high prices.
Right now, you can save over $100 on Simple Truth with digital coupons. Download today at simpletruth.com.
Simple Truth, available exclusively at Kroger.
Pool together all your money with a friend and invest in two Arby's French Dip and Swiss sandwiches for just $6. It's the perfect get-rich-quick on sandwiches scenario. Arby's, we have the meat.
Get ready to experience Little Rock in a whole new light. On December 8th, the inaugural Arkansas Chinese Lantern Festival will fill the Arkansas State Fairgrounds with extraordinary silk structures and lanterns at every turn. These beautiful displays have been enjoyed around the world and will soon debut in Arkansas. Don't miss your chance to experience the festival right here in Arkansas from December 8th until January 14th.
Smith Saddlery has found a new ranch for Old Justice on Highway 65 in Greenbrier. For all the real cowboys and cowgirls and those at heart, Smith Saddlery is what you need to live the part. We're more than just saddles. Smith Saddlery in Greenbrier. Just look for Old Justice.
Hank's end of the year.
Sale of the year.
With power reclining sofa and love seat, $10.99. Man-sized power recliners, $2.99.
And your sales tax paid.
At Hank's Fine Furniture.
And mattresses.
This month at Hogs Meat Market, 3 pounds ground beef, 1 1/4 pound sausage, 2 1/2 pounds pork steaks, 2 1/2 pounds pork chops, and your choice of 5 pounds leg quarters, 3 1/2 pounds chicken fries, or 5 pounds chicken nuggets, 2 1/2 pounds beef patties. Your choice, $39.95. Still the best dressed meat in town.
K4 aerial footage brought to you by ARC UAV. Now from KARK4, your weather authority, Arkansas's certified most accurate forecast with Chief Meteorologist Keith Monahan.
Well, we nudged up that thermostat a bit today and most places got out of the deep freeze. Now, the majority of Arkansas locations were at or above freezing today. The official locations across the state, pretty much the same story, although Harrison officially only 31 this afternoon. It got to freezing up at Fayetteville, 39 at Searcy, up to 45 degrees at Camden, and 44 out at Hot Springs. This evening, just after 6 o'clock, Little Rock metro area, we've got clear skies, and it's really not too cold out there. Temperatures holding a couple degrees either side of 30. Elsewhere across the state, we are seeing temperatures cooling off a little bit quicker in the north, down to 26 at Harrison and Fayetteville. You folks in Batesville currently at 30 degrees, 33 Pine Bluff, 29 at Arkadelphia, and right here in the capital city, clear skies is freezing out there. 32 degrees, although it feels a whole lot better than it has at this time the past couple of days. Right now, winds are out of the northwest at 6, so we have a bit of a wind chill, 26 in the barometer, 30, 29. It is rising. High pressure building in behind a cold front making its way across the state. But satellite radar loop really not making any mention, at least visually, of what that cold front is accompanied by because there's little, if any, moisture associated with it. So you'll notice nothing more than a wind shift to the northwest and north tonight as that front moves south. We're not expecting breezes to be picking up. The area of high pressure from the Arctic that brought us the long period of temperatures below freezing now moving into deep south Texas. Meanwhile, a lot of energy in the atmosphere along the eastern seaboard after a little bit of snow earlier today in northern Florida. Huge storm system is rapidly developing. It is expected to track just off the east coast of the United States. All of these different colored boxes you see are winter storm blizzard warnings, winter weather advisories, freezing rain warnings. It's going to be messy travel. If you've got flights out of Little Rock tomorrow to any of the big cities in the eastern United States or any of the connecting cities as well, check ahead with your airline. Even though we're not expecting any weather problems in the nation's midsection, I'm sure flights are going to be backed up or canceled across much of the East Coast. Those major airports likely to see wind gusts as high as 60 to 70, even 80 miles per hour as that powerful storm system heads up the East Coast. Now, for us, frontal boundary, as I mentioned, will continue moving southeastward overnight tonight. We're not going to see any weather associated with it, significant weather in any case. Now, tomorrow, temperatures will be a bit cooler, but the core of the coolest air, which is not as cold as the last area of high pressure that moved in, will be shifting toward the Ohio Valley. So we're only going to see basically a slowdown to our warm-up. Temperatures tomorrow will indeed be a few degrees cooler. Some places in northern Arkansas likely to stay sub-freezing, but that'll only be for one more day because that area of high pressure continues to head eastward by Friday into Saturday. So a southerly flow redevelops. We're not going to see a lot of moisture with that southerly flow, but we will see temperatures warming up. into the mid-40s for both Friday and Saturday under mainly clear skies. Clouds will quickly increase, though, by Saturday night ahead of a storm system coming in from California. That storm system likely to bring rain to the area beginning about mid to late morning on Sunday. And at this point, it looks like enough warm air will be in all levels of the atmosphere, so it'll just be plain rain. Now, as far as your forecast is concerned, we are looking for high temperatures tomorrow, up to 37 degrees after a start of 19 in Little Rock. A little bit cooler tomorrow night behind that frontal boundary, but only 18. We're not talking single digits here, folks. 45 the high on Friday, 44 on Saturday. Again, quick increase in cloud cover Saturday night. Areas of rain on Sunday, and most of the guidance suggests a half inch to three quarters of an inch of rain by the time it all ramps up Monday morning. But you see temperatures above freezing the whole time. Good news for folks that have to get out there and travel Monday morning. Mm-hmm. But temperatures by Monday afternoon, Tuesday, and Wednesday, low to mid-50s. So I won't say we're done with the cold weather, but at least we're getting a bit of a break.
All right. That's nice because we could certainly use it.
Yeah,
Keith, thanks
sure.
very much.
Thanks,
okay.
Keith. Well, straight ahead, we are going to head to Bryant, where police say a man beat his son and two other women in a series of attacks. We'll have a live report next.
KARK 4 News is sponsored by Layla's Euros and Pizzeria.
Taste authentic Mediterranean cuisine at Layla's Euros and Pizzeria, featuring hummus, falafel, and try our Greek pizza, pasta, and calzones. Satisfy your hunger at Layla's. Visit our two Little Rock locations off Rodney Parham or Highway 10.
Hey fans, the Harlem Globetrotters are coming to Verizon Arena Friday, January 19th, and KARK and Wendy's have teamed up to save you $7 on your tickets to the game. Just stop by the Verizon Arena box office or go online to Ticketmaster.com and use the code Wendy's to save.
Ferguson's Furniture store-wide sale on all 2017 inventory includes USA leather furniture, the best in America. Save up to 50% on this exclusive line of fine leather furniture today. You can also buy 2017 Pennsylvania House bedroom furniture at closeout prices. Pennsylvania House is truly the luxury line of master bedroom furniture, and this is the time to buy. Worth the drive from anywhere in Arkansas. Only at Ferguson's Furniture next to the Walmart in Benton.
More than $400 million. That's more than $6 million a month for the next 5 years. And somebody's going to win it all. But if you are to win that $400 million, you've got to buy your tickets now at any of the 2,000 Arkansas Scholarship Lottery locations. And when you buy your Powerball ticket for the big jackpot, go ahead and ask for the $5 bundle. When you do, you'll get a Powerball with Power Play, a Mega Millions ticket, and a free Natural State jackpot ticket. Three ways to win life-changing jackpots. Ask for the $5 bundle today.
I'm Yolanda Young. My daughter was killed here in Little Rock, Arkansas. We all need to get serious and come together, all communities, to get this stuff under control. My daughter is buried in her prom dress. No one deserves this pain. Help Arkansas declare victory over this violence.
This is your team.
Welcome back to the Pig Trail Nation.
This is Pig Trail Nation on KARK4.
These are my streets.
It's time people know Black Lightning is back.
I thought you were done being a hero.
Brother needs all the exercise he can get.
Black Lightning, series premiere, Tuesday, January 16th on the CW.
We're watching KARK4 News at 6.
A man behind bars after allegedly beating his son and injuring two women in a series of attacks. This man, 50-year-old Curtis Huckabee, is facing multiple charges, including aggravated assault and attempt to commit capital murder. KARK4's Mitch McCoy is live tonight in Bryant, where this all happened. And Mitch, what have you learned from police?
Well, Ashley, good evening. Bryant police tell me that the two women attacked were totally random, and they're still trying to figure out how or why Huckabee picked these two women. One of the women attacked was actually a gas station clerk right here at the Big Red's gas station behind me. This all started early Tuesday morning, about 10 minutes up the road towards the interstate. Police say Curtis Huckabee beat his son, requiring the 23-year-old to need stitches. About an hour later, police say Huckabee went to
to Big Red gas station where we are right now on Reynolds Road and randomly attacked the clerk. Police say he forced the clerk into the parking lot where he severely beat her, then allegedly ran her over with his car. She remains hospitalized but is expected to survive. It was 5 minutes later at another Big Red's. Police say he ordered the clerk to the ground. Investigators say he told her he was with the SEAL Team 6 and she needed to come with him. She was able to hit the panic button before, and that is when he left. Police spotted Huckabee's car. That sparked a high-speed pursuit. We just moments ago got that dash cam into our newsroom. We're still processing that footage. We're going to have that all new on KRK 4 News at 10 o'clock. And of course, the big question here is what sparked all of this? We are learning a lot of new information about what could have sparked this. We're told he's not in the military. We're told by his family he does not have PTSD. All of this new information, we're going to break it down for everyone coming up at 10 o'clock. Reporting live in Bryant, Mitch McCoy, KRK 4 News.
All right, Mitch, we will see you at 10 o'clock. With near record-breaking temperatures this winter, many in Arkansas have fired up their fireplaces. A little bit more than just for ambiance, more for survival. But one Arkansan waking up to her home filled with smoke, they later learned it was all due to improper maintenance to the chimney. One Arkansas Fire Department says over the past couple of weeks, they've gone from no chimney fire calls to getting some every week. The cause of the fire is improper installation and maintenance.
The main thing is just make sure that it's inspected and swept at least once a year. Getting eyes on by a professional can help them to see if something has changed or happened that could be a problem.
Get that inspection. Bagley says sweeping out your chimney, make sure that there's no excessive buildup that could catch fire. Otherwise, to prevent chimney fires, include never using gasoline or kerosene to start a fire and only burning seasoned or dried firewood.
With a new drawing hours away, the Powerball jackpot has jumped to an estimated $460 million. The cash value of that grand prize is $291 million now. The drawing takes place tonight at 9:59, and with ticket sales being cut off an hour beforehand, we want to wish everyone luck and hope the odds are in your favor.
A former Hog is a finalist for the NFL Hall of Fame. Two-time Super Bowl champ Steve Atwater was drafted by the Denver Broncos from the Hogs back in 1989. He played in the NFL for 10 years, 9 years with Broncos and 1 year with the New York Jets. The annual Pro Football Hall of Fame Selection Committee meeting will be held Saturday, February 3rd. We'll let you know what happens there.
And next in sports, it was a rocky start on the road for SEC play for the Razorback men's basketball team.
Missed opportunities last night in Starkville. We had a crew at the hump to see the Hogs drop to 1-1 in conference play. Recap coming up in your Pig Trail Nation report.
Watch live with Kelly and Ryan, weekdays at 11 on KARK4.
It's our half-off after Christmas sale at Family Leisure.
Huge savings store-wide. Save big on pool tables and shuffleboards. Game tables, $99. Theater and massage chairs are priced to move. Spas from $12.99. Hot deals on summer items, too. Half-off after Christmas sale going on right now at Family Leisure.
Hi, Dave Woodman here, and look who I've got with me. From Fairfield Bay, Arkansas, Mr. Bob Light. Bob, I heard you had some really severe low back and neck pain before you saw Dr. Keith Curry, and that's all changed.
Yes, David has. I have a close family friend that saw Dr. Curry years ago, and she's still doing great. I've had one back surgery and didn't want to have another, so I decided to see Dr. Curry as well.
Well, how bad was your pain?
My pain was severe. It was really bad. It was a constant sharp. Went from my back to my legs and feet. It was a full 10 out of 10, and now it's a zero. Dr. Curry has also worked with me through nutrition, and I've lost 20 pounds and feel healthier, a much clearer mind, and much more energy. I could go on and on about Dr. Curry and what he's done to help me and how his treatments have changed my life.
Well, that's great, Bob. Now, what would you tell someone who has severe neck pain or back pain or diabetic neuropathy?
Call Dr. Curry right away. His treatments have changed my life.
Family owned since 1979, Johnston's Home Center in Benton has all your outdoor needs covered. Save during our Husqvarna year-end blowout. Huge discounts on Husqvarna. Save on all riding and zero-turn mowers, trimmers, blowers, chainsaws, and all handheld equipment. On sale now during the Husqvarna year-end closeout. Don't miss out. Low prices and top-notch customer service. That's Johnston's Home Center in Benton.
Mandela. He unified the people of South Africa. He changed the world. This is his journey.
This is your team. Your state.
Welcome back to the Pig Trail Nation.
This is Pig Trail Nation on KARK4. Pig Trail Nation, powered by your Arkansas Select Buick GMC dealers.
It's a half-off after Christmas sale at Family Leisure.
Huge savings store-wide. Save big on pool tables and shuffleboards. Game tables, $99. Theater and massage chairs are priced to move. Spas from $12.99. Hot deals on summer items, too. Half-off after Christmas sale going on right now at Family Leisure.
KARK4 News is sponsored by Arkansas Select Buick GMC dealers. From Fayetteville, high on the hill, this is your Pig Trail Nation report. Powered by your Arkansas Select Buick GMC dealers.
Last night, Mississippi State notched its first victory over a ranked opponent since 2011. It comes at Arkansas's expense. The Razorbacks failed to close after leading most of the second half at the hump, falling 78-75. Miss State took the lead with 39 seconds to go, ending an 18-game losing streak against ranked teams. The Hogs shot 65% from the field in the second half, but they dropped to 11-3 on the season. Mike Irwin saw it all unfold in Starkville.
Arkansas outshot Mississippi State and rebounding was even. So what was the problem for the Hogs tonight? Huge imbalance in points off turnovers and the big ones, second chance points.
I thought that was a big difference. I mean, they got some, you know, some of them, they got some weird bounces, but at the end of the day, you gotta put a body and create some space up there. And my biggest deal is not only got them, they actually scored off of them. They scored right in there. I think the big kid had one, a dude right there, we put them up. It was an offense. We played really good defense. And we didn't come up with the ball. And that cost you. That cost you on the road.
Those were big. They played a big part in winning for them and a big part in losing for us. We just got to get back to the drawing board and just figure out what we can do to close the game out next time. And one thing Coach preaches is we got to box out on the free throw line, and we didn't do it tonight, and it cost us. So we just got to learn from it.
The Razorbacks stay in the top 25, may end up being a short one, but the Razorbacks don't have time to worry about that. They're back on the road Saturday to play an Auburn team that just got through beating Tennessee badly in Knoxville. In Starkville, I'm Mike Irwin for the Pig Trail Nation. Back to you.
Mike, thanks much. Hogs and Auburn Tigers meeting Saturday at 5 at Auburn Arena. Tip time, 5 p.m. This will air on ESPNU. We'll have a crew at that game. Bruce Pearl able to lead his program to a win over his former team last night, taking down UT at UT for the first time as Auburn coach, as Mike mentioned. The Tigers surged late, featured a three-point show. Auburn drained 5 out of its last 6 from behind the arc, putting up 52 second-half points on its way to a 94-84 win at Thompson Bowling Arena. An 11-0 run for the Tigers sealed this one in Knoxville. They've won 11 straight. April 3rd, officially, the Mike Nabors era started at Arkansas. Credit the new Razorback head coach for getting this program back on the right path. This was a 13-17 program last season. Now Arkansas is off to a 10-4 start, including a one-point win on the SEC opener. Razorbacks 51st in the RPI after recently checking in at 49th.
That's just a good thing. So that's been a surprise to me. I wasn't sure with our schedule and the challenges that we faced that we could be at that point that quick. Now, you go to Mississippi State, win or lose, you're going to go up in the RPI. That's the mathematics of it.
Yeah, Miss State brings a 15-0 mark to the court Thursday night. Tip-off is at 8 from Starkville. This one will air on SEC Network. Arkansas looks to pull the upset over the fifth-ranked team in the nation. Mike Nabors doing a lot of great things on the court, off the court as well. That's it for now. We'll send it back to you.
All right, Drew. Thanks, you very much.
All right.
Felt better today.
Oh, I'll tell you what. I mean,
nice break.
The sunshine being out and temperatures soaring into the 30s to around 40. I'll tell you what. It's just, you know, my mind just had palm trees and sandy beaches.
Yeah. Don't really go too far.
Not too
far. Bump your head on some ice.
Yeah, I fell on the ice. Hey, we are going to be cold tonight, upper teens. Tomorrow with a front coming through overnight tonight, a little bit cooler, but still tolerable, 37. Then we're up into the mid-40s for Friday and Saturday. We warm up even more by late in the weekend, but that comes with the chance of rain. Pretty good chance of rain. Half inch to a three-quarter of an inch possible when it winds down early Monday.
All right, Keith, thanks very much.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you tonight at 10.
The Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery is